Alright, so we're here at the Museum of Moving Image. We're here at the first stop, and it is at the Walking Dead section. So they got a lot of things here on display. This is what you see when you walk in. And they have other things. They have a film slate, they have a script for season 5, episode 12, according to here. This is... Wow, so they got like all the notes that they give to them. This is the chair book that they used on set. They got like screens and stuff showing all the episodes. This is really, really cool. They got all this on display, all the books. Wow, and these are the actual books too. This is amazing. Wow. Got more comics over here. Volume 1 and 3. We talk about the pilot episode. We can read that, pause it. We got these slippers right here. Wow. My brother, he would love this because he's a Walking Dead fan. Yeah, I'm not a horror guy like he is, but I'm even like wowed by all this, even though I don't watch the show like that. Okay, and then they're displaying the outfits and everything. They're playing like all the scenes and stuff. If you keep looking around, they have a lot displayed. So yeah, with some more stuff here displayed. Got some of where like the settings and prison. Yeah, if you watch the show, then you're gonna really, 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 really love this all. Yeah, I might even start watching the show after this, like full time, because this is all very, very good. Here's all the weapons. Oh my god. Living in the Dead. Oh boy. This is deadly right here. Let's get up close to this. This is a bicycle girl.
Yeah.
Yeah. Look at all the blood. You got all this, y'all. You got all this here too. So this ain't like the 360 audio thing from the immersive experience, the MJ one, but they do have the headphones here. You can watch this. We could watch it with the headphones on. This one only had like one of the ears working, so I think it was the left ear. So yeah, this is the creepy. Like this is my god. Yeah, but yeah, they dive deep into the fandom here. It's really cool. Over here we have the... Oh my god, we got like... Got them all here. More like these headphone stations. We got a repeat of this. No, they're all different characters. They're faction figures. We got some art over here. This is the last thing you see. That was awesome, and as a not being a fan of the show, that was really, really cool. We have the next one is talking about TV and digital entertainment here. So yeah, before the cinema. So here we'll probably get more info on, you know, moving images itself or like. like they'll mention here about lantern shows, and yeah, again, you can pause to read. Really cool, because you have a list of jobs, and you get a little more info on like what they do in the. So, like, I'll give you an example. If you get an animator, and they just tell you what they do. They'll go in depth with the department, by union, and then just a list of the jobs, and they go in alphabetical order, so it's quite a bit here. So we got everything: story editor, sound designer, yeah, like music composer, arranger, instrumentalist, directors, digital editors, you know, So Zoe Trope is the 1834 toy. So if you look over here, there's a movement. Once you spin it, pretty cool, huh? So I'm gonna spin this one now. Wow. Tell you about it here as well. And there's an image. Let's look at it again, right there. Oh wow, I saw it move a little bit. Over here, they talk about, oh, here's a flip book here. Over here, they talk about stop motion animation. And they have the animation, well, the ones from Coraline. You can actually make your own stop motion animation by recording a few frames. Let's see how this goes. Mine turned out to be incredibly sloppy, so we're not even gonna bother showing it. But we got more here, the cameras and stuff. Oh, hidden Mickey. But all seriousness, these cameras are insane. They have the ones for, well, here are the lights. Here's the color television camera. Over here they have a, this is a, what do they say? It's a, this is what they say for this one. This is awesome. The detail is insane. Here they really go in depth with sound engineering and soundtracks and sound effects. And they have some stuff to do over here regarding that. There's a game lab. I've never seen a computer like this.
Yeah, like this big.
What the heck? Game room. There's a game here called Fill the Basket. It's a sanitation game. You like collect trash. Pretty much every computer has that. So yeah. Look at that microphone. Oh yeah. Yeah, we have a microphone up here. The microphone. Microphones use sound and vibrations. See, they got different types of microphones over here. And they got, yeah, they got, wow. Again, very detailed. Here it's wildly in depth with the music, so let's continue. And we're gonna select the scene, casino. Watch the scene, music's missing. So, watch the large screen. Hold on. So yeah, now they say music's missing from the scene. So now they're telling us to select a song. So I think we can hear like one.
Taxi
I guess.
Driver.
I guess we select that one. All right, now we hear the music with it. Oh yeah, this fits. Oh yeah.
Yeah, it does fit for sure.
Yeah. Wow, that's great. This guy said it was a Walking Dead song. I think the other one was better. The Taxi Driver one fit better. Yeah. This one, I'm a Man from 1955. Alright, see. Oh, here's a da-na-na-na.
Not when I was a little boy. Age of five. I had something in my pocket.
I think the Taxi Driver one was the best one. Editing live television. All the controls that they do and stuff. This is what you get from downstairs. I guess that's how Randy Orton got the name for the signature move. Yeah, we'll be down here later. Look at this.
It's from
Randall Keith Orton, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm digging this set, man. Project shirt, projecting. We have Yoda over here. Is that a Freddy Krueger costume over there? Yeah. And here we have a media lab. It does. Right? It does look like piano a little bit.
Yeah.
Every TV. You know what it's like? It's like an elephant trunk.
Yeah, that too.
We got a movie on display here. It's called At the Party. It's from 1929. It's a 7-minute film, according to the description over there. Sound. So we'll do Simpsons. Watch the scene, some sounds are missing.
You can do it, Lisa. There's nothing in the room but you and the test.
Shut up. Okay. Okay, so they're telling us to, so we could pick different ones. So here's everything I selected. Let's view the finished scene.
You can do it, Lisa. There's nothing in the room but you and the test.
Oh my God. Oh, that's amazing. So now we're in where the reason I came here, the gym has an exhibition. We got Kermit the Frog, Fraggle Rock. They got all of it here. This is not Fraggle Rock, but something else. Oh my God. Oh my God. These are the official puppets they used.
You're asking the official puppets?
These are the ones. These can't be replicas. What the heck? You can watch Jim's earlier work. This is a... oh my... That's a dragon. It's advertising for Chow Mein. man, puppets do a lot of stuff, man. They can do anything. Prime Minister puppets. Yeah, I didn't know Frank Oz did this. And Jim Henson, I'm learning stuff, something new. Here's the sketch for it. And then... Oh my God, they got it! This is awesome. Oh, yeah. Yo, this is insane. I've seen so many pictures of this, and seeing this in person finally is incredible. Hold on. Oh, yeah, so... Wait, what he did was he was... he only moved one of his arms, and then the other arm would control the mouth. And then same with the... They used a lot of these, like, videos. The King of Eight. I remember this film. The original Ernie.
There's Ernie.
Got some of like the games. You know, they got the monster at the end of this book. This, I remember reading this book as a kid, and at the end of the book,
wow.
He's like telling, "Oh, there's, I'm the monster." I never heard of this though. The Muffin character book. I never heard of this. Yeah, Scary Crouch, Barkley the dog design. What? How they'd made the puppets. This is every single episode of the Muppet Show playing all in loop. And here is Statler and Werdolf. This is awesome. Got the Muppet Show logo. You got the scripts and some of the songs. The sketches, the Jim Henson on Johnny Carson show. Maybe if we go back over here,
we got the Swedish Chef. Where to hear but Hobbin Schumer and Fredo Forby.
Yeah,
they all look like they're related to Elmo.
I was about to say. This might have been the inspiration for Elmo then.
Think so?
I mean, hey, look, it's red. They got the no eyelid. Yeah, like this. I think this right there. This screams Elmo, like right here. We got the I forgot this was the band. I think that they had. Yep. I remember now. Yep. God. Oh, there's Fozzie. Oh my god. The Great Muffet Caper. Damn, I gotta watch all these again. It's been so long since I've seen all of these. Here are the Fraggles. Dance. Oh, Uncle Traveling Matt. That's insane, man. I didn't see a Kermit puppet or a Fozzie puppet on display. I don't know if there is one on display. They have these designs and stuff. Never actually go inside this. Let's see what's in here. Yeah, you love it. Oh! Yeah! Oh.
What is that, a bug and a dead person?
Yeah, it's crazy. Then you go under here. And you watch the Muppet Show. What are you selling here today? Oh man. Hello, anyone? No, it's unfortunate. Okay.
Was this a milkshake?
Yeah. Yeah, I guess. I mean, and then these things. Oh, no, don't touch them. Okay. Oh, okay. Calm down. Okay, sir. Okay. All right. Yeah, all right, lovely store you have here. They got all the games here, Donkey Kong, Mortal Kombat, I'll probably play this, Dauntlet, Saxon. All right, I'll play Mortal Kombat. That's, Oh, it's out of order.
Never mind.
You. It's also out of order. What? Dang. So I guess we got some of these. Soundtrack, different soundtrack albums here. Pinocchio, they got the Star Wars, The Wiz. Bodyguard, Dirty Dancing, Purple Rain, All in the Family is on here, Elvis Presley, Eagle, Born Free, Sound of Music, they got everything, Pink Panther, and over here you have more stuff over here, Monkees, this is awesome. Danny Thomas show. Yo, is that the, this is the, okay, so this right here came from a show called the Howdy Doody Show. It was a show from like the
sounds funny.
Yeah, it was a show in the 50s for children, yeah. Yeah, some wacky show. The first Disney thing I see here is the Pluto Squeeze toy. Well, Muffets is Disney, so I don't know why I'm saying that. And Pinocchio. What am I saying then? I've got Pinocchio here.
Oh.
Here's Pinocchio. Yeah, Snow White. It's a game? Dang. It's cool that they keep these on display. Star Trek over here. Some idiot would probably go up here and say, oh, that's the Wiggles. Yeah, the McDonald's. Yo, they got a McDonald's Happy Meal box from the 70s, from the 80s, like 79. Yeah. Still got more starch. Barbie and Ken dolls. More stuff. We got Star Wars over here. Magazines. Got books over here. Watches. This is the Queensboro Bridge. And we have the... Oh, God, no. This is the Wiz. They got the lion here. They got the scarecrow. They got the Tin Man. Yo. This is the... Yeah, they got the crows. They got all over here. You can't win. Production design here. From the... What was this from? They look very familiar. I just never knew where they were from. Interesting. Oh, I'm an idiot. It says the Dark Crystal right here in the land of Thra. And then right here, they're showing it right here in action. Wow. Oh boy, this is Doubtfire.
I was comparing it to this.
Man, rest in peace, Robin Williams, man.
Yeah.
More displays over here. They got Chewbacca over here. They got, Oh, they got some Jim Carrey.
The mask.
Yep, so now we're in the gift shop. Some Blu-ray. They got some Sesame Street stuff in the back. They got, The Walking Dead stuff in the front. They got a lot of stuff here. It's like books. Feature presentation. I love this so much. They got the, Oh, it's just like popcorn box. Nice. Chaplin archives. It's like a young Vince McMahon over here. Vincent Price biography. They got, Interesting. Yeah. Overall, this was an amazing museum. I recommend everyone come here. We got Freddy Krueger. And then we have the book, the more books. They're still selling Christmas books. Yeah. They got, more Christmas stuff still here. So Muppet Christmas Carol and Muppet Movie, Christmas filming.
So that was my time at the Museum of Moving Image. I went along with my NYC friend. His name is Joe, and for those who don't know, he has the same name as me, which is great. But that was we had a great time. We looked at everything, and especially I just left very, very impressed with all the artifacts and the exact, like, I fanboyed so hard at the Jim Henson section. It was just amazing, and I'm happy that people can come back and expect something new, because some of these exhibits, like the Walking Dead one, are not there forever. So a different experience every time. So that is what this was, and I really hope that you all can get to come here one day, because it's great. And if you love movies, and if you love how they work, and just what they use for them, along with some of your favorite movie franchises, this is the perfect place for you. So check it out. It is the Museum of Moving Image. And yeah, that's the video. Expect another vlog, where the next place that we will go to is Candytopia, which is a candy museum in Manhattan. So I'll see you all in that video. Bye-bye, guys.